In this episode, we will be discussing the important boxes, graphs, figures, as well as important terms appearing in Chapter 6 of Economic Survey 2018-19. The chapter deals with the topic, How does policy uncertainty affect investment? Let's look at the first figure. Surges in economic policy uncertainty increase the systematic risk and thereby the cost of capital in the economy. As a result, higher economic policy uncertainty lowers investment, especially because of the irreversibility of investment. A globally recognized attempt of quantifying economic policy uncertainty is the development of an economic policy uncertainty or the EPU Index. The index is created by quantifying newspaper coverage of policy-related economic uncertainty. The index reflects the frequency of articles in leading newspapers that contain the following triple: economic or economy, uncertain or uncertainty, and one or more of policy-related words such as fiscal policy, monetary policy, PMO, parliament, etc. Only those articles that have words from all three categories are counted for measuring economic policy uncertainty. Figure 1 shows that the EPU index was the highest in 2011-12, coinciding with the years of policy paralysis. Further, it shows that the economic policy uncertainty has been secularly declining from July 2012 onwards. As is expected, episodes of greater uncertainty, such as the taper tantrum in 2013, exhibit elevated levels of economic policy uncertainty index. Taper tantrum refers to the uncertainty faced by emerging markets following the announcement by the Federal Reserve of US of tapering their policy of monetary easing. Moving on to the next figure. Figure 2 shows that the EPU index for India shows peaks in the few months of 2011 and 12, reflecting the policy paralysis during that period, which also witnessed the problems of high twin deficits. A situation when economy faces two deficits, fiscal deficit and current account deficit, and high inflation, which intensified macroeconomic vulnerability. The EPU index and macroeconomic vulnerability are very strongly correlated, as the figure 2 shows almost same movements of both indices over time. Also, the EPU index is strongly correlated to volatility in exchange rate, stock market and inflation rate as well as repo rate. Fiscal deficit. It is the difference between the government's total expenditure and its total receipts, excluding the borrowing. Current account deficit. The current account measures the flow of goods, services and investments into and out of the country. A nation runs into a deficit if the value of the goods and services it imports exceeds the value of those it exports. Repo rate. Repo rate or repurchase rate is the rate of interest at which RBI lends to banks for short periods. This is being done by RBI purchases government bonds from banks with an agreement to sell it back at a specified date. The next figure, figure 9, shows that the economic policy uncertainty in India moved closely in tandem with the global uncertainty until 2014. However, it started diverging since early 2015 and seems to have completely decoupled in 2018. In recent times, while the economic policy uncertainty has been increasing across the world, including in US, UK and China, India's economic policy uncertainty has been falling. The low economic policy uncertainty index for India in the last 1 year points towards resilience of the economy even in times of global trade uncertainty. For example, the rising trade tensions between US and China, uncertainty about the outcome of Brexit, slower world growth, etc. The next figure, figure 11, shows that after falling for close to a decade since 2008, investment activity and gross fixed capital formation or GFCF as a proportion of GDP, commonly referred to as the fixed investment rate, has been recovering since the quarter 1 of 2017-18. Factors responsible for this recovery are The continued resolution of the twin balance sheet problem following the implementation of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code of 2016. Recapitalization of banks, focus on improvement in business climate via measures to improve ease of doing business, clarity in the business for FDI liberalization, etc. Twin balance sheet problem refers to the stress on balance sheets of banks due to the non-performing assets or NPAs or bad loans on one hand and heavily indebted corporates on the other. Insolvency and bankruptcy. Insolvency is the situation where the debtor is not in a position to pay back the creditor. Bankruptcy is the legal declaration of insolvency. According to the Bankruptcy and Insolvency Code 2016, when a default in repayment occurs, creditors gain control over debtors' assets and must take decisions to resolve the insolvency within a 180-day period. Let's look at the next figure. Figure 12 shows that there is a strong negative relationship between the EPU index and investment growth. Shocks to economic policy uncertainty are associated with a subsequent decline in investment, and other macroeconomic variables like industrial production, GDP, stock market, etc. Both foreign direct investment, FDI flows, and foreign institutional investment or FII flows are also negatively correlated to EPU index, implying that inflows into the economy are affected by the high uncertainty in economic policy. Moving on. Apart from economic policy uncertainty, other factors affecting investment are borrowing costs. Borrowing costs are negatively associated with investment as they reflect higher input costs. As expected, fixed investment is negatively correlated with repo rate, weighted average lending rate, and marginal cost of lending rates. Inflation. Investment growth is positively correlated to wholesale price inflation, but negatively correlated to consumer price inflation. This may be due to the fact that the higher wholesale prices realized by producer would trigger greater investment as business would find it profitable to do so, whereas consumers paying higher consumer prices may dampen the demand. Capacity utilization. The extent to which productive capacity of a plant, firm, or country is being used in the generation of goods and services in any quarter is expected to have a positive relationship with investment growth in the following quarter, as excess unutilized capacity in the previous quarter may lower the need for new investment in the current quarter. Volatility of exchange rate. The foreign component of investment, that is FII and FDI, are negatively related to the volatility of exchange rate. If the volatility of exchange rate is higher, it may decrease the demand of foreign inflows via FII and FDI. Generally, portfolio investments or short-term investments are more affected by volatility in exchange rate as compared to FDI, which is a longer-term investment. Marginal cost of lending rates. It is the minimum interest rate of a bank below which it cannot lend. MCLR, implemented in 2016, replaced the earlier base rate system to determine the lending rates for commercial banks. It was introduced to improve the transmission of policy rates into the lending rates of banks. At the end, we will focus on some policy recommendations as suggested by the Economic Survey for reducing economic policy uncertainties. Top-level policymakers must ensure that their policy actions are predictable, provide forward guidance on the stance of policy, maintain broad consistency in actual policy, and reduce ambiguity or arbitrariness in policy implementation. Economic Policy Uncertainty Index must become an important index that policymakers at the highest level monitor on a quarterly basis. Also, construction of economic policy uncertainty sub-indices must be encouraged to capture economic policy uncertainty stemming from fiscal policy, tax policy, monetary policy, trade policy, and banking policy. As organizations in the private sector compete and seek the highest level of quality certifications, government departments must be mandated to similarly seek quality certifications as quality assurance processes will significantly reduce economic policy uncertainty. That is all for this episode. We will see you next time with Chapter 7. Stay tuned.